News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the language you need to talk about the news. Hi, I'm Neil, and joining me today is Sian. Sian, what's our story?
Hi. The story today is about something very, very big that has been built in China.
Something big that's been built in China? Is it a wall?
It's not a wall. It's a different shape.
Okay. Let's find out some more from this BBC World Service news bulletin.
China has completed the installation of the world's largest radio telescope. The last panel was fitted into the centre of the giant dish located on a remote mountain in the southwestern province of Guizhou.
So, a huge radio telescope has just been built on a mountain in China.
Okay, well, sounds interesting. Let's have a look at some of the language that's been used to talk about that story. You've been looking around. What have you found?
Okay, so I've picked out three words. Okay, the first word, well, it's a group of words, and they are massive, gigantic, giant.
Okay.
And the second is extraterrestrial. And the third is eavesdrop.
So, massive, gigantic, giant, all words meaning very, very big. Extraterrestrial, meaning coming from outside of planet Earth, and eavesdrop, that's secretly listen, to secretly listen to a conversation. So, Sian, how are these words appearing in the media?
Okay, so the first group of words all mean very, very big. And because it's such an enormous telescope, the media has been emphasising that with synonyms. Mm-hmm. So, for example, in the GP Times, we have in the headline, China's massive 500-metre fast telescope ready to search the skies in September. So we have massive, meaning very, very big.
Yeah.
And in the same article, we have in the first paragraph, new photos show that China's gigantic 500-metre dish. So again, we have another word meaning very, very big.
We have a few of these, don't we?
And they're all in all of these articles. So we've got gigantic, huge, enormous.
Humongous.
Massive, humongous.
Ginormous?
Ginormous is a combination between gigantic and enormous.
Yeah, slightly childish word.
Quite, yeah, yeah. But I think it's becoming more common nowadays. So.
Right, okay.
Ginormous.
There's an interesting thing with these extreme adjectives, isn't there?
So you can't use the adverb very because they're already extreme.
Yeah.
So we can't grade them. So instead of saying very enormous, you would say absolutely enormous.
Or extremely.
Or extremely, yeah.
Yeah, you can't say very enormous.
No.
Okay, what have you got next?
Okay, so the next word we have is extraterrestrial. Mm-hmm. And in the Telegraph, we have work has finished on the world's largest radio telescope, which will hunt for extraterrestrial life and explore space.
Yeah.
So extra here as a prefix means outside or beyond.
Mm-hmm.
So extraterrestrial is outside planet Earth,
right.
So aliens.
E.T.
E.T.
Which, in fact,
is extraterrestrial.
Yes.
Yes, E.T. the alien. And we don't have to use it just for space. So we can use extra, for example, extraordinary is beyond ordinary.
Yeah. There's a strange word, isn't there, when children at school do something outside of the normal activities. They play sport,
yes.
They're part of a club. They're called
extracurricular activities.
Yeah.
So music, for example, as well.
Yeah. Extracurricular outside of the curricula.
Yeah. Outside the normal syllabus.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Okay. What's next?
Okay. And the final word is eavesdrop. So in the Crusader Journal, we have the headline, China to develop giant radio telescope to eavesdrop on potential alien life. So we have another word meaning big here, giant, and eavesdrop.
Yes, so to eavesdrop is, it's quite a negative word really, isn't it?
Well, if you're eavesdropping, you're listening to someone's conversation, but secretly they don't know about it. So I guess it's strange for this, because obviously this telescope is not very secretive, it's enormous, but the idea is that we're going to be secretly listening in to aliens on other planets.
By using this word, it adds drama, doesn't it? And that's a kind of typical thing you'll find in headlines, words that are dramatic in order to make the whole thing more exciting.
Exactly. And the same with the extreme adjectives. It's all to build drama. But eavesdrop, we can use just to describe a conversation when you're listening into someone's conversation.
Yeah.
For example, if you're on the bus and you're listening to the people behind you, you're eavesdropping.
Yes. Mm-hmm. OK, well, let's have a little bit more on this story from the BBC's Celia Hatton.
It's difficult to overstate the size of China's new radio telescope. With a diameter of 500 metres, it equals 30 football fields. Or, as one of its creators explains, if the dish-like telescope was filled with wine, every individual on Earth, about 7 billion people, could drink about 5 bottles from it. The radio telescope will function like a giant ear, detecting sounds from far-off galaxies. Scientists say the new instrument will explore distant places like never before, finding new stars and even searching for alien life.
The BBC's Celia Hatton there. Do you drink wine from a telescope, Sian?
I never have, but I'm amazed by how much wine you can get from this telescope.
It's a very interesting comparison.
Yeah.
OK, it's time for our Facebook challenge. We set this question to our Facebook followers. We've been looking at extreme adjectives, and we put up a picture of an extremely clean kitchen.
Mm-hmm. Was it your kitchen, Neil?
Wasn't my kitchen. No, it wasn't. And we asked the question, which extreme adjective means very, very clean? Is it A, minuscule, B, hideous, or C, spotless? What sort of response did we get?
Well, I like Ol Holmes' response. He says, sorry, I was distracted by the beautiful kitchen in the picture, which is a good answer. But the majority of people did get it correct. It was spotless. So spotless meaning very, very clean.
Yes, so clean that there isn't a single spot.
Exactly. The other two, minuscule, meaning very, very small, mm-hmm. tiny, and hideous, meaning very ugly.
OK, well, let's move away from very ugly
yeah.
on to a summary of the words we've looked at.
OK, so we looked at some synonyms for very, very big. For example, massive, gigantic, giant and huge.
Mm-hmm.
And we looked at extraterrestrial, meaning coming from outside planet Earth. And finally, eavesdrop, to secretly listen to a conversation.
Yes, well, people don't need to secretly listen to us. They can find us on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where there's all sorts of materials to help people with their English. Thanks for joining us and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.